Hello, my name is Jenna, and I am a developer at Melonport. So I've been involved in the Ethereum community for a bit now, and working full-time doing this.
Okay, when did you involve into crypto space? And yeah.
So I got introduced into the crypto blockchain space in 2012. At the time it was Bitcoin. It was already very interesting, but it didn't raise my interest enough to kind of like go full-time there. And at the time I was working in finance in the hedge fund industry. But I still kept an eye on like on the space and what was going on there, reading a lot. And and then Ethereum came, and then I was like, okay, it clicked for me. I was like, this is huge. I was working full-time in finance. I didn't have a coding background, so I was like, I really need to get like, you know, this technical background to be able to understand what's going on like in a deeper way. I learned programming, was reading and educating myself a lot out of personal interest. And eventually I just decided that I wanted to actually work full time. So I was like going to conferences, meeting people, and eventually I met the Melonport team.
Yeah, so what is your role at Melonport?
So at Melonport, I am a developer. I basically build our front end, our JavaScript library. I bring my financial background and input into our decisions in building the protocol, the Melon protocol.
Does your finance background help in programming?
Yeah, totally. We're building a decentralized asset management system. So basically we're building the infrastructure for tomorrow's asset management or next generation asset management. So we have to kind of like code into the smart contracts all the logic by which an investment fund works. Having a financial background is extremely helpful and valuable.
So Melonport is doing asset management on the blockchain, right?
Exactly. We are building a protocol for asset management on the blockchain. So it's a completely decentralized and open source protocol. The main values that we have are permissionless, ownerless, and reliable. So it's just like an open source software for anyone to create a fund, to manage a fund, for people to invest in other people's funds.
Okay, you're a developer, I'm a developer, so I will ask you about the Oyente,
yeah,
which is quite a standard in the blockchain space. So can you tell us more about this?
Yeah, sure. Oyente is a project where we have one person working full-time on that. It's a great developer tool that allows you to verify your smart contract. So basically you run your smart contract through Oyente, and it will warn you or let you know if any known vulnerabilities are in your code. So one good example is the re-entrancy bug that we all know about since the DAO hack.
Yeah.
If your code, your smart contract, contains potentially this this weakness, Oyente will flag it out and let you know. So it's a way for smart contract developers to be more confident in their code. It won't find unknown issues, but it will find all the issues that we've kind of like gathered so far.
Okay.
And we keep iterating and adding. When new issues or vulnerabilities are found on smart contracts, we just add in the code of Oyente. So as time passes, Oyente becomes much more valuable.
So you're doing mostly JavaScript or any Solidity?
I do mostly JavaScript.
Yeah, that's cool. So what do you think is the best about the Ethereum community?
The Ethereum community is amazing. If I had to name one thing, it's just, you know, the eagerness of everyone here to learn from each other and to kind of grow and move forward together. So I really like that. And also just, you know, this the vision that we all share for the world that we're building, it's really awesome.
Okay, how do you think Melonport will change the landscape of asset management?
Because it's a completely decentralized and open source permissionless network, Melonport is the company, by the way, building the Melon protocol. So we should maybe talk about the Melon protocol.
Yeah.
So the Melon protocol lowers barriers to entry into the asset management industry, which today is extremely, you know, exclusive to a very few number of people. It's extremely expensive to run a fund, cumbersome, time-consuming, and our software like kind of removes all of that. So it gives access to a much deeper talent pool. So that's why we think it's gonna completely disrupt the asset management industry.
Okay, so if we are a group of people, then we can create an fund mm-hmm. on your protocol.
Exactly, yes. That's correct.
Okay, so yeah, that removes the barriers. So we at Chronologic are maintaining the Ethereum alarm clock for scheduling transactions. Do you think that's useful for the Ethereum ecosystem, maybe for the asset management?
Yeah, it's definitely useful. Scheduling future transactions seems like something that we should already have, but it turns out
exactly.
It's not. And we actually ran into that issue at Melonport a few months ago. We have a function. So if you have a fund and I want to invest in your fund, I'm going to invest, but the investment will be executed, I mean, needs to be executed a few blocks later, because we want to prevent one agent to have an information edge on the price from the other. So basically we had to find a way to schedule a transaction in the future, and back at the time we didn't have this this option, which we had, like, we now have a workaround, but it will be very nice if in the future we can schedule that transaction to happen a few minutes later.
Okay, do you have any message for the Ethereum community?
I hope the community grows and keeps being as amazing as it is right now, and that we all keep our eyes focused on the goal, building a decentralized and transparent world.
Okay, thank you for an amazing talk, and good luck with the Melon part.
Thank you for your time.